actress and host, and today we're shooting Home Plus Living Issue of my humble abode. So let's check it out.
So Melody, can you tell us a little bit about the hills that you're wearing?
A little bit? There's nothing to say about it. No kidding! It's just really sexy! Check it out, it's got gold trimming and that little touch on the heel as well. It's just a really pair of sexy heels.
Melody, smile. I'm so sad.
Okay, I can do
it. Because I cannot breathe. I'm breathing like small bits of air.
Keep in step now.
What
side?
I will not even the cats. So I had to put this.
Even the cats? Yeah.
Yeah, the cats I didn't love, but there was one time Mocha did a couple of things. He ran right in. Boom! Then he. That's Mocha. He's our younger cat that we adopted from the Cat Welfare Society. It's just that so happens I was doing quite a lot for Cat Welfare, and then I was hosting some of their shows. And then one of my friends there, she's the president at that time, Veron, very smart. Hey Mel, carry this cat, carry. It's okay, I carry it. I never stop carrying, I carry all the way home.
That we play on Kiss 92. I'm currently into soundtracks. Well, I've always been into soundtracks. So the latest one is the soundtrack of Mortal Instruments, the movie. And from that soundtrack, I really love Jessie J's single called Magnetic. Yeah, it's really an awesome song. I keep playing it over and over again. Yeah, and the lyrics too, it's all this empowering music, a bit like Katy Perry. Yeah, she's a toss between that. Katy Perry's Raw and Magnetic by Jessie J.
What's the one word that describes your decorating style?
Chapalang? Okay. anything goes really, maybe a little bit more eclectic, modern, mixed with a bit of vintage. Yeah. So I only have I have three words, I don't really have one word, sorry.
Are you ever feeling low in the way? So how does your decorating style reflect you as a person?
Well, sometimes it's kind of like an organized mess, so yeah, not that I'm a messy person, but I like to collect stuff, and you know, in my travels, we do buy little trinkets here and there, so it just shows that we love traveling, and me as a person, I like to explore new things, and I'll keep it, so all these little things, perhaps. perhaps kind of, you know, gives a reflection of myself that I'm quite sentimental, you know, maybe a little bit of romantic. And yeah, and I like the old stuff, like the vintage, so there's still a lot of, you know, the retro thing in me that I love from the past, like the 50s, 60s, so whenever I can, I do collect stuff from that era.
I noticed a lot of stuff about New York.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Why, right?
It was just an idea that my husband and I had because we love New York. We have friends there, and in terms of being of a city, like a vibrant city, the first thing in my mind is New York. And it's just a very exciting place and a lot of great food. Atmosphere, Central Park. So when we were decorating our home, I just wanted a little bit of New York. So there's the pillows I'll find, a picture of us in New York, even little boxes like this. This is from New York. And yeah, little trinkets here and there. And I know certain things I bought from there. It doesn't look like New York, but I bought it from there. So yeah, it's just a little piece of New York at home.
Name one thing most people won't know about you.
I can get quite creative. I love to sew, I love to make stuff and come up with my own, whatever, like if I have to frame something up or make a card or just make something. I actually enjoy doing that, just come up with my own design. So that's something, when I have the time, I love to do that.
What's the biggest feast you've ever made at
Honestly, I'm not much of a cook or a chef per se. I've always wanted to learn, and but I can cook to survive. That's what we always tell our friends. I cook to survive, my husband cooks to impress, because he's Peranakan, he's got all the Nonya dishes down pat. But I've cooked before, and I think the biggest, a simple, just a steak and mashed potatoes, some steamed broccoli, yeah, soup. That's probably like my biggest for now. So far we've shot four different shots around the house, living room, the landing area and the bedroom. Now they are preparing the kitchen and putting some of the products that aren't mine together with those that are mine.
And look out for the October and November issue of Home Plus Living, because it will be featuring my husband.